Hafaday, and hello everybody. Happy New Year. I'm Jason Salas and this is KUM News Extra. If you're streaming us or watching us on KUM TV, you picked a great night to tune in because we are talking first off on the show about microgreens, and I have two people on the KUM couch who are experts in this field. We have Michelle and Chef Mirko. Hafaday to you both.
Hafaday.
Happy New Year. Michelle, welcome back. We haven't had you here in some time. Last time we were talking about aquaponics.
Yes, that's right.
Because this particular subject is very near and dear to your heart. And Chef, of course, anything that is even remotely edible.
Everything.
You can prepare it, you can make
it. If it's a sustainable, better.
Exactly. Sustainable, you can turn it into art, and it is, if it's good for you, you absolutely want to bring this to the people of Guam. So, Michelle, I always thought microgreens was kind of like, is it an umbrella term? Encapsulating many different types of greens? Or what particular plant are we talking about?
Actually, it is sort of encapsulating many types of greens. You've heard of baby greens before.
Sure.
And sprouts. Mm-hmm. So microgreens is in between that stage of growth for most of your herbs and vegetables.
Okay, cool. And we have some here right now. What are we looking at? I know we've got three of these.
These pots. I've brought the red rambo radish, the purple reddish color.
Red rambo radish.
And there's arugula and Mizuna mustard.
Okay. Red rambo radish. I like that name. All right.
You should try some.
Yeah.
So it actually is.
I'm trying to come up with some sort of first blood reference, but I can't make one. So.
It could be a regular radish if it grew to a mature stage.
But, okay. And what we saw right there was a professional at work. So Chef, when it comes to actually like harvesting or preparing this for some sort of meal, exactly how did you cut that?
Yes, I just go to as close as I can, and I'm gonna try to get out as much I can from. Do not touch the soil, and it means is to have all the sprout we have, because that's what we can utilize from the bottom to the top.
Okay, and there's so much more flavor in the stem, right?
Yes, in the stem and in the leaves, because mm-hmm. that and is the chlorophyll is going to come out.
Okay.
That's where it's, and it's always, I say, you know, so pretty. Is, you know, is kind of already an art.
And if you could, just hold that up so we can get like a nice shot of that. There you go. All right. You only got a couple there, Chef, but if you were going to plate like a really nice dish, would you use this as a garnish, or would you use this to add some sort of flavor profile to say, like, if it was, how would you pair this? With steak or with pasta?
I would say I will not make only this as a salad because it's not getting enough, mm-hmm. but it can be a top of something else. Like you say, on the side of the steak, is it the garnish on there, which you're going to have the steak as the main ingredient when you eat it, and the microgreen, which is giving you the flavor, the spice, and the freshness of the steak. Mm-hmm.
And I know for those of you who are watching us in HD right now, the color, Michelle, is like really jumps mm-hmm. out at you because you know you've got again the red rambo and these colors and everything, the greens and the purples. It looks very very vibrant.
It's very aesthetically pleasing,
it
and
is.
I think that's one of the selling points for microgreens as well. Not just that they're very flavorful and also nutrient dense, but you know, they're very nice as garnishes. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so when it comes to the health benefits and everything like that, what about this can nourish the body, and where does this benefit us?
So some studies have shown that some microgreens, they haven't done full studies on all of them, but for example, broccoli, you know, microgreens can be 40 times or more nutrient than its mature size. So. Mm-hmm. So the baby greens can be a lot healthier too.
And if you could hold that up right there, Michelle, since the camera's on you, we'll just get a nice shot of that. Look at that.
This is the arugula.
And Chef has basically just plated, although you know it's on a piece of paper. You know, he's plated those. Very nice. Arugula, of course, has many, many uses and many
and
different
can
types of
dishes. Smell it already too.
I wish we had smell-o-vision, everybody out there. But you know, trust me, this is really good.
Yeah.
Okay. And obviously, with only a few pieces of this, you can not only aesthetically accentuate a dish, but you know, mm-hmm. like you can really add to its nutritional value.
Yes, you can.
You don't need to use like a whole, but like Chef was saying, you can't make a salad out of this, but you don't really need that much.
Yeah. You don't need that much, but I just at home, I do put a lot just because I grow so much at home. So
there you go. If some is good,
and
more
it's
is
easier
better.
Than going to the store for me personally.
But you guys, sustainability is why we're here talking today mm-hmm. and everything like that. So Michelle, could you tell, because sure. your passion is sustainability. You want to do things that are good for the environment, for the island, at a macro mm-hmm. level for the planet and everything like that. What makes this type of growing so good?
So the thing about growing microgreens, and our organization doesn't just focus on microgreens. We do a lot of things that deal with growing and harvesting your own food at home. Mm-hmm. But microgreens in particular are very easy to grow. They take about 7 to 10 days to harvest. So for a lot of the beginner growers out there, microgreens is a good place to start for them, because they might think, oh, I don't have a green thumb, I can't grow my own food.
That's
well, we've proven through our workshops that even if you've never grown anything before, you could be successful with the microgreens.
So even for, let's just say, the very scientific, very technical term, moron like me, right? I could actually get this right, because I've been known to screw up ice cubes and toast. I could actually be productive with this.
Yes, as long as you water.
It's doing by yourself. Yeah. It means you cannot mess it up. You put it there, you watch it, it's gonna come.
I like the sound of that. Okay, and now, you know, for purposes of working in the studio, we've got like these little, nice little pots here and everything like that. But is this literally the way that I can grow this, like in my house? I don't have to have like a whole, like a light room or a whole, you know.
Yeah, literally you can grow it like this. So for the workshops, we will use small containers like that. But we use recyclable containers that we have gotten from Kadu. So the restaurant Kadu, we kind of have a relationship with them where they encourage their customers to bring back their plastic containers. They clean them, they give them to us, and then we use those to show people that you can use any container around your house to turn it into a planter as
well. So that's
with
Chef Lenny, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's right. A shout out to Chef Lenny. Good job, man. Yeah. We appreciate it. Okay, yeah, so in about a week and a half, you can actually have fully harvestable microgreens.
Yep, and it doesn't take a lot. You can grow it right by your window. You can grow it on shelves vertically. So even if you have a very small apartment, I've seen people growing it in their laundry room before. So that's kind of one of the reasons we do start with this as well. It's very easy in small spaces.
Okay, Chef, in your own work as a professional culinary artist and everything, how have you used, you know, microgreens?
I really like it. The first key is sustainable, and it means is, and first you growing by yourself. You know, this is very nice. It's very intensive flavor, more than when it's fully growing, and is an art already to work. You combine a different color and different shape, and you can put it by yourself, you can bound it or together. You can put on fish, you can put on meat, you can put in anywhere, because they have their own a little taste. I call it kind of a concentration of flavor, because you have just the leaves, and when you get in it to start to bite in, you have that kind of input right away.
And when you're cooking in a hotel environment where you're serving hundreds, if not thousands, of meals per day,
correct,
that's very, very good.
Yes, and this I really like it for to say as a more than 1,000 people is for the finish. Touch is for, you know, if you are at home and you want to show off some friends is coming over, you say, let me going to cut what I make it. You cut two leaves and you put on top of even the regular salad, you say, this is different. And if you can taste the different when you get to the regular salad, or you're going to bite in of this kind of small leaves, you get to say, wow, it tastes different.
All
it
right.
is more concentrated, and it's the pretty of you did it. You start from zero and you have it in your house, or you have it at the restaurant and you can cut it and fresh to put in your salad.
Very well. Okay, guys, I got to take us into commercial break. Chef, we know we can always find you at the Hyatt and your amazing work there. So
yes,
thank you very much. Michelle, if anybody wants to find out more about this, how can they contact your organization?
They can visit gusustainable.org and get more information, especially about the workshop. Actually, you can sign up by calling the Hyatt to sign up for that workshop, or 687-6713 and 687-6491.
Okay, please reserve a space for me, because I want to learn how I can actually make this work for me, because I'm really excited about it. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank
you. And I'm excited to see you guys on the flip side of this break after in a bit.